Yo, so I just published the 14th release of Winhance, which is version 26.01.12, and it's got a few very important bug fixes and then some stuff with the translations. And in this video, I just want to take you through a very quick rundown of what exactly changed and where you can expect to see these changes in the new release. So first off, if you already had Winhance installed, the next time you launch it, you'll see this update notification. And to install the update, you can just click on Install Now. It'll download the latest version, then launch it. Like you can see here, you can just accept the terms and do a normal installation, just like I'm doing now. It's going to relaunch Winhance now on the latest version. And that is now, like I said, version 26.01.12. Now, getting into the change log of this release, there was a Chinese language options issue in the Winhance UI. So if we go over to settings and then to the language selection here, the Chinese simplified and traditional Chinese had the exact same letters, which made it confusing, and someone helped me change that. So thanks for that. Then I implemented a fix for the external app detection, and it's actually for the external apps and the Windows apps, so that the detection accuracy is a lot better. So there were quite a few issues related to this, but one of the things that ended up happening is like Microsoft Edge falsely showing as installed despite it being removed from the system. So this was a visual bug in Winhance where stuff like Microsoft Edge and OneDrive and a few other apps would show as installed, but they were actually removed. They aren't present on the system anymore. So I implemented a fix for that, and in my testing, everything works fine now. But you guys can go ahead and test and let me know if there's any other issues with regards to that. The next thing is I added Dutch translations, and that was a request by someone. So if you want to see Winhance in your language, go ahead, create an issue on the GitHub page with the language that you'd like to see in Winhance, and then I'll add that translation to Winhance as well. So we've got Dutch, Netherlands, and then I also added the Belgian Dutch, but they're kind of the same. But I did add both of them just so both of them are there. Then next, there was an issue with the Wim and ESD conversions. So there was this bug where if you used Wim util to do a conversion between ESD to Wim or Wim.ESD, the source file wasn't actually deleted, and then it ended up with both of the install files on that Windows image. So the expected result would be that the source file, meaning if you converted from Wim to ESD, then the Wim file would be deleted automatically. So I did implement a fix for that, and in my testing, the source file is now deleted. But I also added something else that in case both Wim and ESD files are found when using the Wim util, Winhance will now tell you in the form of this card here that both Wim and ESD have been found. Then you can also see both of their sizes there. And then you can decide which one you want to delete and keep on your Windows ISO file. And then we get to probably the most important bug fix in this release, and that is to let Winget self-update before doing any package installations. So it prevents outdated Winget installations, because there was a lot of you who tried using the previous release of Winance who wasn't able to install any external software. And when I released the previous version of Winance, which was 25.12.12, those external app installations were definitely working. But what happened in the meantime is new certificates got released for Winget. And if Winget wasn't up to date, then the certificates or timestamps didn't match and it just errored out. So in my testing, even not using Winance, just using Winget through the command line, if you try to install something that uses the MS store as the source for that installation, which is basically the Microsoft store, then it just gave this unexpected error because the server certificate did not match any of the expected values because the Winget version was outdated. So when I tested this on this specific Windows installation that I tested it on, it had version 1.10.390 of Winget, but you can see in the background here the latest Windows package manager that was available was version 1.12.440. So it was really out of date. Now, the reason I think this happened is if I show you in Winance, I think it might be related to two different settings or a combination of both of them. If we go to the Windows update settings, if you have a disabled policy, then WinGet probably wouldn't be able to update via Windows Update. But what I actually think it is related to is the option here to not auto update Microsoft Store apps, because the Microsoft App Installer that you can see here can be updated via the Microsoft Store. So I think the issue with WinGet not updating might be related to one of these two settings, but that doesn't matter anymore, because now when you select any application that you want to install, whether it's Windows apps or in the external software, basically any installation that uses WinGet for the installation, it'll first check if WinGet is installed. If it's installed, it'll then check if WinGet is up to date, and if it's not up to date, then it'll update WinGet and only then proceed with the installation of the app or apps that you selected to be installed via WinOns. So that was the last and I think most important bug fix of this release. And if you've now updated to the latest release, I'd love to hear if all of these issues have been solved for you. They were certainly solved in my testing. And if you have any issues in WinOns, if you click on the bug icon there, it'll take you straight to the WinOns issues page, and then you can create a new issue and describe clearly what your issue is, and I'll have a look at your issue and get it fixed as best I can. Remember, I'm relying on you guys, the community, to help me make WinOns the best application that it can be. So don't be afraid to let me know about any issues or improvements. I'm not saying I will follow through on every single request I get, but I will surely take it into consideration. Now, with all of that being said, thanks so much for watching this video. If you're interested in seeing the development process of this update, I'm going to release a video about it on my dev channel in the next few days or so, and I'll make sure to link it on screen here. But if it's not released yet, it'll just be replaced by another video on this channel. But that's all I have for you today. Go ahead and like the video, leave a comment with your thoughts down below, subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed, and I'll talk to all of you guys soon.